Welcome to the ReachX podcast. Today we are with Regina Mayor, who serves as KPMG's Global Head of Energy. Welcome to the podcast. Let me just jump straight on to the first question. We're seeing quite a kerfuffle in the oil and gas markets. We've had sub $30 prices at one point, which have now recovered to somewhere in the mid-30s. Nobody seems to think that this downturn caused by the friction between Saudi Arabia and Russia is likely to go away anytime soon. Yet, investment needs to go on. The sector needs to move on because of the world's energy needs. Now, a pressing question here is, how do those players, those investors commissioning oil and gas projects, or are perhaps at final investment decision stage, react to what we are witnessing out there in the market?
Well, clearly there's a completely different price scenario that has to be factored into the investment case that they're evaluating. And they would need to stress test it against a 20, a 30, a 40. Whereas perhaps when they were approaching FID in fourth quarter of last year, they were looking at a $50 scenario. So I believe we will see more projects that get delayed, especially those that are longer lead time efforts, and that companies will be retracting and retrenching their capital programs and their operating expenses.
It's a global world. It's a global investor community. A lot of people are raising question marks as to how bankable the oil and gas sector is. Yet at the same time, whether you look at the IEA, the EIA, OPEC, whichever sort of data aggregator you rely on, oil and gas is going to play a vital role in the world's energy needs. So in that context, what should investors make of the bankability of the oil and gas sector over the medium term, let's say?
Medium term, I think those stocks are still incredibly valuable. We still consume 100 million barrels per day of fossil fuels, and there's no sensible alternative. When you look at the market value loss that this sector has taken overall just in the last 3 days, it's an incredibly steep drop. So longer term, these stocks are quite bankable. Right now, you could consider them to be quite a bargain, but it's been a double whammy, sort of a 1-2 punch, as Warren Buffett has put it, with the coronavirus, market volatility, and the oil price war triggered between the Saudis and the Russians that have created 50%+ market value losses in many of these companies that have really strong underlying fundamentals that are part of the fossil fuel needs to drive the economy while we're still going through the energy transition. I think they're incredibly bankable, but you know, investors will have to make their own calls.
If you look at how the sector reacts to the crisis, the response is always that this initial panic. After all, this is not the first crisis that the oil and gas sector has faced. We had the financial crisis, we had the dot-com bust all those years ago. We also had the previous oil price downturn, which was not so long ago in 2015, mm-hmm. 2016. Right. So here we are. Here's another crisis. I think the two major ones that spring to my mind would be the global financial crisis versus the current one, where we are seeing, courtesy of the coronavirus, a sudden drop in demand. So from where you sit, how do the two crises compare in terms of the impact on the sector?
Well, the 2008-2009 global financial crisis had demand destruction components of it, right? People retracted, they didn't spend, they didn't travel, people worried about their budgets, and that had a meaningful impact on energy consumption. This is a even worse demand destruction event. I mean, I don't think we've seen anything like it really since the global financial crisis, and it's probably going even back to 9/11. And it's still unfolding, right? So we thought maybe it was contained to China, and now we have Italy, now we have repercussions in Europe, we have repercussions in the US. So the markets don't understand what the total demand destruction picture is going to look like. And then on top of that, we have supply increases that are being announced, and it's almost like, no, I can do more than you can. So this race to the top, which becomes a race to the bottom, that further confounds price. So given both of those components, I don't think anything is comparable from what we've seen in the past. I think it is unprecedented because we have this real big unknown swing in demand being decreased and a real unknown swing in potential supply increases.
And one final question to round off our discussion. From where you sit, it looks like 2020 is going to be a very tough year for the sector. Do you think perhaps confidence returning early in the new year in 2021 or perhaps Q1 or Q2 in 2021? Or it's a bit early to say that right now.
It's way too early to say. And my takeaway from the 2015-2016 oil price price war that was created by OPEC, it took so much longer to unwind that. And it was frustrating, I think, for OPEC in particular, because they thought that they could drive the market price back up as quickly as they were able to drive the market price back down. And the genie's out of the bottle, and you're not going to be able to get it back in, and the markets are overly jittery already. So I don't think confidence returns until at least through the end of the year, if not through 2021. Or at least early 2021, and confidence returning is predicated on getting control of the coronavirus and mitigating future cases and letting the virus wind its way out of the system, and OPEC demonstrating that they can restrict supply to get supply and demand back into balance.
Thank you very much for your time. That was Regina Mayor, who serves as KPMG's Global Head of Energy. For more on ReachX podcasts, go to reachx.co. Thank you for listening.